Packers.
Ready to get this one started. A fairly short kick. Lane opens here. He's past the 30.
On the return, the Packers take over first and 10 at their own 34-yard line.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Working from the gun, Rodgers. And able to find Alan Lazard.
Rodgers pass.
And he'll be taken down, but not before. 15 yards right off the bat. And a quick first down. A nice run. So second and 5 coming up.
Brandon Graham.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
Second and 5 at the 42-yard line.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones.
Rodgers.
And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with 3rd and 1.
And it's 3rd.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back, and it could turn into a big game downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
He's got his man, Valdes-Scantling. And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
A gain of
9 yards that time. Nice job keeping that opening drive alive. And they're in plus territory, that part of the field where you really want to convert on 3rd down. They did.
Big time pickup for them. And now I think the aggressive play callers think to themselves, this part of the field, I take my shot at the end zone. Because the closer you get to the end zone, the field gets condensed. Makes it a lot tougher to run those routes. You still got a chance to actually run past people right now. Take your shot at the end zone early in the down and distance count.
Here's 2nd and 10 now from the 29. That's thrown quickly out wide to Lazard. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. 2 yards the loss, and now 3rd and 12. The Eagles call on the extra defensive back here as they prepare for a stop on 3rd down. Rodgers again now. They're going for Lazard, but this is intercepted. Picked off around the 27. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. How about the big boys snagging one? You don't see that every week.
No, you don't, but a lot of them are just reliving their old dreams, going back to when they were in youth football and in high school. They didn't always play defensive line. Some of them actually handled the football, and you can see the flashback when he grabbed that one.
Wentz and the Eagles now with a 1st and 10 at the 31-yard line. Miles Sanders, first carry of the game.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Second and 10 at the 31-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Throwing is Wentz. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 11 yards there. First down.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus. And indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
On first and 10, it's Sanders.
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown.
Miles Sanders, 58 yards. And the Eagles have taken the early lead.
Jake Elliott on.
Well, earlier in the week when they had their scouting report meeting, this was the explosiveness that they talked about trying to contain. They were concerned about it all week, yet he's still.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And here's Lewis. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
At their own 29-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. First quarter, and now he already has two interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw four interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
On the tackle that time, Dean Lowry.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
It's a second down run with Sanders. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first.
Brings up third and four.
From the gun, it's Wentz. And that is intercepted. Or was it? Wait, they'll say no. No interception. He did not keep the feet in bounds, apparently. So that's just going to be an incompletion.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
The field goal unit's going to stay put on the sideline. They're going to go on fourth down here. They'll go for it. It's Wentz. Open man, it's Rager. He's got it. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. Well, we kind of looked at each other as they decided to go for it, but in the end, great execution, a 6-yard gain, and it all works out. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Here we are, y'all. Check 99.
Wentz on the give to Sanders. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. 6-0 our score after one.
Here is nothing.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. They'll run it, Sanders. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. First and goal.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
They'll run with Sanders. He gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4.
The tackle made by
and a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier. It was bidding for a second. 2nd and goal from inside the 5. Now Sanders. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If this is all he gets, he'll just sit there to have the guy to already. And get some more. And get some more. He'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. And he'll be out right at the 35.
The Packers take over 1st and 10 at their own 35-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball, try to get things settled down a little bit.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Rodgers throwing quickly out to Adams. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one good for a 1st down pickup of 18 yards.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
Aaron Jones.
Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
From the gun on 3rd down, Rodgers got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. And he is going to have a Packers 1st down by about a yard as they find a way to convert there on 3rd down and 5.
1st down, Green Bay.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. A first carry now for the BYU man. It's Jamal Williams.
Number 30.
Javon Hargrave there on the stop.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot.
And the pressure gets there. He'll go down. It's a sack. And it is going to bring us to the 2-minute warning. Fletcher Cox in there to take him down on what will take us to the 2-minute warning.
And long.
coming up at halftime. Jonathan Coachman will join us from Orlando with our halftime report. But business to take care of before we get there.
A two-minute drill before the coach's two-minute drill.
On third and long, it's Rodgers. That's complete to Lazard. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. Took nearly the entire first half, but a first red zone opportunity for them here. They've got a first and 10 at the 15. From the gun, it's Rodgers. And Rodgers intercepted a third time. Picked off by Jalen Mills.
You hear me laughing, partner, and I'm not laughing at the situation. But sometimes you just get yourself into a rut. It's hard to shake yourself out of it.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 39-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared.
And this is caught inside the five. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Marquise Goodwin, 61 yards. And the Eagles add on to their lead. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From the six. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
Return. The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Rodgers throwing quickly out wide. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Complete to Alan Lazard.
Shotgun now for Rodgers. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. They came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. Looking deep for Adams. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Packers.
Complete to number
17. Devontae Adams, 54 touchdown yards. And the Packers make some inroads here on that deficit. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. A lot of football, full half to be played. And the Eagles dodge a bullet. They cover it up. A second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Great. They'll run on first down. Sanders. And he'll take this one down to about the 40.
The ball carrier.
Preston Smith there on the stop. Well, we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
On second and nine, Wentz, left side here to Sanders. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
First and 10.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now here's Goodwin with another jet sweep. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
That's the reason we ball for. Circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
They'll come up now on second and a yard. Shotgun now for Wentz. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock. He was trying to find DeSean Jackson that time. And it's third and short.
And one.
And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter. A final shot before half for Wentz. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
At their own 28-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Another run here with Sanders. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 39-yard line.
Play fake to Sanders. Now here's Wentz. And I think that one might have been intercepted, but he will be ruled out of bounds. So this will go only as incomplete.
Love the idea, love the concept, but you got to leave a little room on the sideline so he can fade into it when he makes the catch. That was thrown too close to it for the receiver to make a play.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10. Working from the gun, Wentz. And he finds his tight end, it's Ertz.
Wentz is
5 yards, now it's 3rd and 5.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. It worked very well there for a first down.
And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Yeah, another good run there. He's been such a big part of their success here this afternoon. And that last carry, it puts him over 100 yards now for the day.
He's got the hook up here to DeSean Jackson.
That's good.
And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 24-yard line.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Complete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything, and against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. Now Wentz. Goodwin able to haul it in. He'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down at the 9. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and that'll bring up a second and goal.
At the Packers' 9-yard line.
Now Wentz. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he is out of bounds here. Able to get 9 out of that pitch and catch, but now third and goal.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Third and goal now, mere inches from pay dirt.
He's not gonna get me.
They're going to run this with a tight end. And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Push further out in front.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely, you also drain clock too in a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And here we are almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over one.
Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the Ram, applying the heat off the edge.
Loss on the play. It's second down.
Another try after the first down sack. Rodgers open on the left side. This is Valdez-Scantling.
Rodgers pass.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Packers who have the football but in need of points as we begin quarter number four. On third down, Rodgers. And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. Derek Barnett able to maneuver in for the sack.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Looking deep for Adams. It got his man complete. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Can't get away, and he's taken down. Derek Barnett picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
It's second down.
Throwing on second and long. Rodgers. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I'll tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Yeah, once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. Throwing on third and long. Rodgers over the middle. That's caught by Adams. And he'll get up near the 45. He'll spot it at the 44. Just a 5-yard pickup, but it leads to fourth down.
It's now fourth down.
The Packers go for it. Rodgers. He's going to air one out. That's caught at the 25. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Rodgers now on first down. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Jalen Mills. And now look at him go. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case. Beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
And that will bump the lead up to 26. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Kick is away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. They'll drop this underneath for Jones. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less, as they come up on second and inches.
At the 34-yard line.
Now a dump off here complete, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
And the
now Rodgers. He'll find Jones again, complete. Not much there, only a yard. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and nine.
Brings up second and nine.
A quick throw out to Adams on the perimeter. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Rodgers to throw on third and one. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Jalen Mills. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 45-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And barring mistakes, they should be able to kneel this one out and finish it off. And there's only one timeout remaining on the defensive side of the ball, so that doesn't really come into play either.
Escaping the pressure right.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off by Darnell Savage.
Okay, it's real simple to say from here, but we know that sometimes as a quarterback, you've got to know when to say when and just throw it away. Flushed out to the right, tries to make something out of nothing here, and he winds up floating one downfield that gets intercepted.
He's going to let it fly. And now here is another interception. Picked up by Mikel Roby Coleman. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot. And now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground.
Number 26.
Brought down that time by Christian Kirksey.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball on the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
Let's get it together, defense. Let's get it together. Bang, 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 bang. Sponge, sponge, sponge. No, no, no. Check one. Sunday, Sunday.
Wentz to throw. And give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown. And the blowout continues. They seemingly just continue to score at will. And as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
And I love how you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win. But one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ballgame.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From the six. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
The return. The Packers take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive? And he's going to go down. Back at his own 5-yard line. It's a sack. Give the sack to Fletcher Cox.
I think normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. But he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Back near the goal line, here's Rodgers. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Avante Maddox.
Rodgers pass. Intercepted. The Eagles take over first and 10 at the 46-yard line.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
Well, partner, when a team's up this big, this late in the game, I always wonder what's their motivation, because if it's me, I'm thinking about pulling on the reins a little bit. But for them, I don't think it's in their DNA. It's not their head coach's makeup at all. I think his opinion is, you stop us, we're not supposed to pull back ourselves.
Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
48, Packers 8. Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. Now a crease here as he's past the 30.
Today's 48.
Offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
That'll do it for crew. I'm Brandon Gaunt. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. The Eagles are winners here as we say so long from Philadelphia.
Stuck in my ways. They say I'm the chosen one to see it in my face. Get this one and I'm holding on.